Another round of severe weather will hit the Dandenong Ranges this week, with heavy rain expected to fell more trees. The warnings come as Kalorama residents scramble to clear the town dubbed Ground Zero. Laura Turner with the latest.
What was dense forest that stood for more than 100 years obliterated in a night?
It's quite devastating. Yeah, it's really amazing. And yeah, it's just hard to comprehend.
This stretch between Mount Dandenong and Kalorama now emerging as the worst hit. The local kindergarten smashed, and just down the road, Errol Lobo's home is split in half.
Within 10 seconds of following Angelie, I heard a crack. And then I heard an almighty bang.
Five trees fell in one hit, dividing his home of 25 years.
It was terrifying, that noise. It's still reverberating in my mind.
He and his daughter escaped with their lives just.
And from there we rushed in here.
Not far from here, the beloved William Ricketts Sanctuary, famous for its Aboriginal sculptures, hit hard by the trees that once formed the canopy above. And Lee Burgess lives in the middle of one of the worst hit streets. He's on day five of the cleanup. And for a climate scientist, even he was mind blown.
It's only the biggest and strongest trees that have fallen. They're just not conditioned for an event of that magnitude from that direction.
This forest here is what authorities are calling Ground Zero. The devastation is extraordinary, but more heavy rain is expected to fall later this week. And they're saying, believe it or not, what you're seeing here could get much worse.
The likelihood of trees falling is 100%. There will be more trees fall. There are hundreds, if not thousands, of compromised trees.
And it's already beginning. Tamika Fletcher's home in Belgrave survived last week's storm, only to be flattened last night.
All of a sudden, just out of nowhere, it was this massive bang, and the tree just came through the house.
And thousands of Hills residents facing that heavy rain, but this time in the dark. Right now in Monbulk, there's still 1,080 homes without power. 930 in Mount Evelyn, 900 in Alinda, almost 900 in Moorlbark, 680 in Kalorama, and 530 in Callista. AusNet says it will be at least Thursday before the lights come on. Recovery will be a lot longer for a community prepared for bushfire, but blindsided by a winter monster.
We will continue living here, I guess. We won't run away from this place.
Laura Turner, Nine News.